Tesla has reached yet another important manufacturing milestone. The automaker announced on Saturday that its Texas Gigafactory has recently produced its 10,000th Model Y SUV. The accomplishment may be good news for those hoping to purchase a Cybertruck next year. Welcome to Tech Heaven, and in this video we'll take a look at Tesla's Giga Texas producing its 10,000th Tesla Model Y and future updates. Curious to know? Let's find out! Tesla intends to manufacture the pickup truck primarily in Texas. The automaker had planned to begin volume production in 2021, but the Cybertruck was pushed back to 2022 and then to 2023. According to multiple reports, a bottleneck related to the company's next-generation 4680 battery cells is one of the reasons Tesla's next EV has yet to arrive. Tesla CEO Elon Musk stated in 2020 that the technology would lead to electric vehicles that are less expensive than cars with combustion engines. However, Tesla and battery partner Panasonic had yet to produce the cells at scale at the time. And it wasn't until this past June that they appeared to be ready for a production surge. That is why the Model Y milestone is significant. Tesla began selling a new SUV variant with 4680 battery cells in April. It has a range of 279 miles on a single charge and costs $59,990. Tesla did not specify how many of the new standard range AWD variants had been produced as of Saturday. The Texas Gigafactory is currently producing more than 1,000 Model Y vehicles per week and is on track to produce 2,000 units every 7 days. Elon Musk was quick to point out during the Q2 2022 earnings call that Tesla is not yet reliant on its 4680 cells. Model Ys are being manufactured in Texas, but only a subset of them have 4680 structural battery packs. Those that do not have the 4680 batteries are outfitted with the company's 2170 cells, which are similar to the Model Ys produced at the Fremont factory. Aerial photos taken at Tesla's Gigafactory Texas complex indicate that the company is making progress in its efforts to ramp up production of 4680 structural battery packs for its best-selling all-electric crossover. The images, which were shared by Giga Texas observer and drone operator Joe Tegmeyer, showed a large number of 4680 structural battery packs stored on one of Giga Texas' upper floors. There are a few indicators that the batteries photographed at Giga Texas were 4680 structural packs. The inclusion of seat mounting frames on the battery packs themselves was immediately visible in the images. According to Monroe and Associates Teardown, these seat mounting frames are where the Texas-made Model Y seats are directly installed. By the way, if you're watching us for the first time, make sure to hit that subscribe button and turn on notifications so you can enjoy our future videos while getting updated. Getting back to the topic, the images of the 4680 structural packs at Giga Texas sparked a flurry of speculation in the EV community, with some speculating that the battery packs were most likely being assembled there. This speculation makes sense, given that Tesla's pilot production plan for next-generation cells at Cato Road in Fremont, California, appears to be focused on producing 4680 cells rather than the entire structural battery pack. The discovery of structural battery packs at Giga Texas is encouraging for Tesla's 4680 ramp. Tesla has been relatively quiet about the progress of the 4680 program, with Elon Musk and other Tesla executives merely stating that the next generation cells will be relevant in the coming year. Still, seeing the battery packs filling up some areas of Giga Texas today is quite exciting and encouraging. Tesla's structural battery packs are an important part of the company's next generation vehicle design. Structural batteries, in conjunction with megacasts, enables Tesla's electric vehicles to use their batteries as structural components. According to Tesla, this reduces production costs while also making vehicles safer. Musk also stated that Tesla could create a small electric boat for the Giga Texas Public Park, dubbed an ecological paradise. The remarks came after documents revealed that Tesla is expanding its factory by 5,000 square feet, confirming the existence of the ecological paradise. Tesla filed a permit to expand Giga Texas by 12 acres, or more than 5,000 square feet. According to the documents, Tesla applied for an increase in its limits construction in terms of both acreage and square footage. Its new application listed 280 acres, up from 268 acres, and 12,196,800 square feet, up from 11,674,080 square feet. Musk confirmed that the Giga Texas expansion would pave the way for the ecological paradise he mentioned when Tesla announced the Austin factory. However, Musk stated that the plant will need to be more financially secure before it begins developing the land specifically for the project. However, the application itself indicates that Tesla is undoubtedly preparing. The Tesla CEO then revealed more information about the ecological paradise design. Musk stated that the trail showcasing the natural beauty of Austin city limits will eventually extend to downtown Austin, so you can walk, bike, or kayak. Musk also hinted that Tesla could create small electric Tesla boats with a retro-futuristic Victorian design. Some of Musk's Twitter followers even shared designs of what the CEO's description could potentially lead to. There have been numerous renders of potential Tesla boats in the past, but the company has never formally committed to building watercraft, despite what you may see online. Musk has mentioned it in the past, but Tesla is currently preoccupied with its current product lineup, manufacturing improvements, and ramping up its two new production plants. It is unlikely that any developments regarding a Tesla boat will occur for at least a few years. It is not unreasonable to believe Musk would be interested as well. He still has his Lotus Esprit S1, the underwater vehicle featured in the 1977 James Bond film The Spy Who Loved Me. During the 2019 shareholders meeting, Musk also stated, "You can actually have a submarine car, it's like technically possible. I believe there will be a small market for this. Small but vivacious. It'd be a distraction, but perhaps we'll build one as a show car." It was reported a few months ago that Tesla's new car factories in Texas and Berlin are losing billions of dollars as they struggle to increase production due to a battery shortage and China port issues. Musk said in an interview, "Right now, both the Berlin and Austin factories are massive money furnaces, okay? It's really like a huge roaring sound, which is the sound of money on fire," Musk said in a May 31st interview. Tesla's Texas factory produces a tiny number of cars due to difficulties in ramping up production of its new 4680 batteries and tools to make its conventional 2170 batteries being stuck in ports in China, according to Musk. "This is all going to get fixed real quick," he added, "but it will take a lot of attention." He claims that its Berlin plant is in slightly better position because it began using traditional 2170 batteries for cars built there. Tesla's primary concern, he stated, is how do we keep the factories running so we can pay people and not go bankrupt. Tesla's Gigafactory Texas has been named the Manufacturing Project of the Year by Area Development magazine. Texas Governor Greg Abbott announced on Twitter that Tesla's Gigafactory had been named Manufacturing Project of the Year, as well as the state's 9th Gold Shovel Award. This award was given to Texas because it is said to be the best state in America for new economic development projects. Area Development magazine stated in its article about Tesla that Giga Texas could create an additional 4,000 jobs on top of its 5,000 promised. According to the magazine, Tesla planned career opportunities early on as a result of its partnership with the Del Valle ISD, a collaborative student training program, and other collaborations with higher education institutions. According to Area Development magazine, Tesla very quickly started turning dirt and putting up steel after announcing Austin as the location of its newest Gigafactory. Despite all of the headlines about job losses, the news outlet pointed out that there were other headlines about major job creations plans, many of which were this year's top projects. And with that being said, it's time to end our video. But before that, we'd like to know your thoughts about Giga Texas. Let us know in the comments. Like this video and make sure to subscribe to the channel for more amazing videos like this. We'll see you in the next video.